As we look at the layout of York Comprehensive High School, you'll notice four parking lots. There are two on either side of the pavilion that can be used as spectator parking. There is one just outside the band room that can be used for judges and workers. The one larger one on the athletic side will be used for unit parking. Unit parking is labeled in blue, the other three are labeled in red. At this time, we're viewing the unit parking, and we'll pan around and also view one of the spectator parking lots, which leads to the pavilion. We'll also continue to pan around to see where the units will enter the building. This is a 360 view of this side of the building and the parking lots. Closer look of the spectator parking, and we'll pan over to the walkway to the pavilion where spectators will enter. Here we get a view of the Floyd D. Johnson Technology Center, where the second spectator parking lot will be located. Now let's learn the unit flow. Once the unit enters, it's just a short distance to the left or to the right to the locker rooms and the restrooms. You'll see another set of doors that will take you straight out of the wrestling gym and into the auxiliary gym to possibly be used for equipment. We are now on the other side of those doors inside the auxiliary gym. Straight ahead once more, you'll see an additional set of doors that will lead you across a hallway into the main gym. We're now at those doors on the other side of the auxiliary gym, about to cross the hall and walk straight into the main gym.
Yeah.
journey up one of the four flights of stairs located in the four corners of the gym. This flight of stairs leads to the faculty workout room that can be used as a break room for judges. Gym and also the lobby of the auditorium. To the right we'll have to us the pavilion, which is where spectators will enter the building, and to the left we have the cafeteria and concession area. Look at the concession area. We'll also be going into the cafeteria. To the left and to the right, in the lobby, just before entering the cafeteria, we have men's and women's restrooms. There's also an additional set of men's and women's restrooms located on the other side of the lobby, which is right outside of the pavilion. Restrooms located right outside of the pavilion. As we enter the pavilion, we see where spectators will enter York Comprehensive High School. Spaces available to us for this event. One of these is this PE classroom. It's a large classroom separated by a partition. We'll visit the other side in just a second. This partition can be removed to create one large space for critique, for unit storage, director's hospitality, or whatever else is needed. Additional spaces would be the York Comprehensive High School band room. This space could be used for whatever is needed, but would probably be the best space needed for a rain plan. Other additional spaces that are available that can be used for the event include the dance drama room and three art classes. They are denoted in green on the flowchart.